Hey guys, it's been a long time since I posted a video, but today we're going to learn how to draft a circle pattern. This is going to be a multiple part series, and in the next few videos I'll be showing you how to use circles to make stuff like a skirt, a cape, and other things. To start, let's get into the drafting of a circle. I know a lot of people get confused by the math that comes with making circles, so I'm really excited to show you guys the circle calculator I made. I'm going to go ahead and explain each part. So the top here is where you can input your circumference and the length of your skirt, and then the rest of the cells will populate automatically with the numbers that you need. The calculator is also sectioned out by types of circles you need, with a full circle cut into two pieces, a half circle, and a quarter circle. I've also made a part where it tells you how much yards of fabric you'll need based on what circle you choose. To start, let's use the calculator and input the two required measurements, the waist circumference or wherever you want your skirt to start, and the length of your skirt. Then you have to decide which circle you want to make. For this tutorial, I'm going to make a full circle. I usually like to draft the circle straight onto the fabric, especially when working with really big circles, but it's also handy to have a paper pattern to reuse in the future. For the full circle, I'm just going to draft half of the circle on paper and cut the fabric out on the fold to get the full circle. Your paper should be big enough to fit the width and length measurements with an inch or so to spare in each dimension. To start, take your skirt length and measure it out along the edge of your paper. Then take your diameter and measure that. If you're doing a half circle, multiply your diameter by 2 and mark that instead. Then follow it by your desired skirt length again. The total length should match the length section under the circle you are making, give or take a few centimeters. Then get the center point of your length by either folding your paper in half or marking out half of the length measurement. You're going to repeat the same step at the top of the paper and then draw a straight line connecting the two points together. Now take your radius measurement and, starting from the center point, mark out points so that you create a half circle once all the marks are connected. If you're making a half circle, use your diameter measurement instead of the radius. Next, take the width measurement in your respective circle section. If you're doing a full circle, take the width in the full circle cut in two pieces section and plot out points coming out from the center point in order to create the edge of your skirt. If you're doing a full or half circle skirt, you'll end up with a half circle once you connect all the marks. Next, you're going to want to add your seam allowance to the bottom and the top of your circle pattern. Next, you can cut out half of your pattern and then just fold it over and trace it so that you can get a perfect copy on the other side. If you're making a quarter circle, start off by making a square using your length measurement. Now, pick a corner and start marking off your length measurement along the paper so that you end up with a curved line when you connect the dots. To make the waist portion, take your radius and multiply it by 4. Using that number, start from the same corner and mark off points, then draw your curve in. Next, mark your seam allowances and then you can cut your pattern out. And if your paper is too short, you can take the scrap piece of paper and then just tape it and extend your seam allowance and then just cut it right off. Just a little tip to finish your pattern. Here I'm marking the waist circumference and the skirt length that I used for this pattern so that I know when I reuse it in the future. Next, using the scrap piece of paper left over, we're going to make the waistband, which is just a rectangle which is going to be the length of your waist measurement divided by 2 plus a half inch for seam allowance. And then as wide as you want your waistband to be, multiplied by 2 with your seam allowances added. And that's it. Now you have your pattern. So make sure you're subscribed so that you know when the next video is coming out, which is going to be how to assemble your circle skirt. Thank you so much for watching. I'll see you next time.